Do you find yourself gravitating towards a specific color combination or specific types of colors in different seasons, or are you just like
I smear everything on the face whenever the F I want to?
Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to today's video where I'm going to chat about 10 palettes that make me think of winter. And if you're new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love to hear about brands that no one else is talking about, if you want to be entertained, if you are slightly orcish like me, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. Let me explain the slightly orcish. It means olive. I am a light warm olive, and if you are olive as well, then you are one of mine. Join us, because we still have a band. It's Nightmare Before Christmas. We're still practicing. You can play any instrument that you want. Yes, but 10 palettes that I think of when I think of winter. I did this one last year as well. Now, the criteria for me is that these are palettes that have launched this year or come into my collection this year. So I can kind of, do it every year if I want to. So yeah, let's just, without further ado, start. They are not ranked. I have done videos with them all. We're just going to get into it. Okay, I have kind of grouped it by brand a little bit. So let's just start with the one that is on top, which is from Unique Beauty. This one was PR, and it's the Dark Souls palette. This was technically more along the lines of the Her Halloweeny palette, but the colors that are in here, it just makes me think of winter. And it's a little bit more of the icier pastels that I kind of want to play with this time of year. So yeah, the shade Ghoul, it's that it's, is it a periwinkle? I have no idea. Is it? I don't know. But yeah, I'm just going to swatch this shade for you guys. And then I'm just going to leave that here. Do I need to say more? Yes. Yeah, and it's just shimmery goodness. What can I say? I think that it's that iciness that I really, really like this time of year. And that is what this palette is giving me. And the quality is amazing. Then the next palette that I pulled, also from Unique Beauty, from her spring collection, actually. But it's kind of the same thing. It's the Bubble Time palette. Again, with the more the iciness. Only these are more in the green. Kind of a greeny minty, but still a little bit more icy. And yeah, he did shade Exfoliate again. She does shimmer so well. But let's also do the shade Chill. Right? Stunning. Yeah. Oh. The next brand I'm going to mention is Sigil. And she's just on a roll, honestly. In case you are wondering, the snake palette is either already in my possession or it's still on its way. Let's start with the one that I grabbed when I went pulling for palettes for this video. This is the one that I grabbed instantly, and it's the Chinchilla palette from Sigil. This one, I got this in winter. I was non-stop. I wore this non-stop every time I was going somewhere, I was not filming, this was the palette that I wore. It's cool toned, but it's, this does not really have that iciness, but it has that cool tone. And there's just something about this color combination and the way that she made the shades that I'm like, yeah. And then this shade, honestly, she does them so well. Let's just, because I can. I have mentioned it before. I think this one is in stock right now. She has brought it back a few times. But if you cannot get your hands on this one, you can kind of get a similar vibe. So basically the look that I can create with this one, I can kind of create with this. Although this is a little bit more lavender, this is a little bit more blue. Maybe that is helpful. The next one that I'm going to show you from Sigil is, well, it's also from Sigil. It's one of her newer ones. And this one is not the icy at all. This is more along the lines of your toasty one. It's the Chestnut, the Chestnut Toad palette. This is The chestnut palette. When I did the look, I basically played in the top row and then I played in the bottom row. The top row was a very, very, very pretty green, gray green, olive. Oh, it was stunning. And then when I played in the bottom row, I was like, I feel like a chestnut. Oh no, I'm getting a package. I feel like a chestnut. So this is just that the toastiness that I also really, really want this time of year. Fun fact is that I can really see that when it is getting autumn, the leaves are starting to turn, I'm really more into the warmer shade. And then when winter is coming, I'm still in the same shade, but then added on with that iciness and I don't know. I don't really know how to explain it. It's the toastiness that I want. It's not really wheat because it's cold as hell outside. Now, the next brand that I'm going to mention is Colourpop. I only pulled one from Colourpop, but this is one that I actually only really want to play with in winter. I'm thinking about right now. And that's the Baroque palette. This was, I think, their holiday from last year, part of their holiday, I don't remember, but this is it. It came into my collection pretty late, but this, and I know that I always say that I don't really like blue shades. These blues are very much, very much up my alley. There's just something about this combination that I love to play with this time of year. Not in summer, I don't know why, and there's nothing wrong with doing anything anytime, you do you, but I just found out that for me, I just gravitate, I'm very much, what I want to smear on my eyes is depending on the weather, on my mood, and that's basically it, and it changes daily, but I do know that this is just one of the palettes that I want to play with now, and not any other time of the year, almost. What can I say? I'm extra like that. The next palette that I'm going to mention is, I was also PR, yeah. It's the Giant Wolves palette from Odin's Eye in collaboration with Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner. Now this one is sold out. I don't know if they will bring it back. But yeah, again, with the, you have a little bit of the blue and then that iciness here, but you also have some of the warmer, no, that's not true because there are cool tones, but there's just what I said with the toastiness, that's what this palette gives me as well. So it gives me and the iciness and a little bit more of the toastiness up top, and the quality is just amazing. So yeah, if you have this palette, I know you'll love this palette. So can we don't look at that finger, but can we just look at this finger, the shade Eternal. And then here you have those shades that I just mentioned on the Baroque palette. You know, the darker, brownier, bluier. I don't know. But it makes me think of winter. And there's wolves on the front. So that makes me doubly think of winter. And Annette is from Norway. And in my mind, Norway is always cold. So I know it's not true, but what can I say? The next palette that I'm going to mention is from BH Cosmetics. And it is the Paris palette. It's kind of a common theme, isn't it? It's basically the iciness, blue. It's just, there's just a common, and then yeah, red also as well. There's just a combination with this, which makes me think of this as a winter palette. And I know that there will be people who are not agreeing with me on that.
But it's my video and I can do what I want to.
I don't know. This combination between the blue and the red makes me feel of winter. Makes me think of winter. Feel like winter, that kind of thing. Quality is amazing, by the way. This blew me away. Then the next palette that I'm going to show you is the only palette that I haven't filmed with as I'm filming this video, and I don't know exactly when you're seeing this video. There is a video coming with this palette though. This is a palette that was PR. And it's actually a collab with three amazing ladies here on YouTube. And I will link all their channels down below. This is the That Time of Year palette with the collaboration between Gourmand Girls and Debutante, Adventures of Zinnia and Brutally Honest Beauty. Here she is. What? This screams winter. For me at least. Now I know that there are a lot of people who are using this all year round, and there's nothing wrong with that at all. It's just that, you know, with the theme that it has, but also again those blue shades, the And then also here the greens, here a little bit more of the Christmassy vibe, you know. It's a lot of, again, a lot of iciness, a lot of... So, yeah, that's it. What can I say? I don't know the quality because I haven't used it yet. But it is one that needs to be in this video because it's the ultimate winter palette almost. Then I am going to mention my personal winter palette that I I don't know if it is the favorite out of the entire stack that I have, but it is very much up there. Just saying, it's this one, the Iceland palette from Nomad, the Land of Fire and Ice. Here she is. This was their winter release from, I think, last year? Or was it in the beginning of this year? I don't know, but it's in this video, as you can see. Again, it's the iciness that is in here. That is basically the overlaying theme of this palette. And then with the gnomes, you know, it's... What's not to think wintry about this? Quality is amazing. And I had so much fun with this palette. And again, this is something that you can wear every day if you want to. But for me, this really encompasses the season that we are in right now, which is winter for me on the Northern Hemisphere. Yeah. Okay. Then the last one that I'm going to mention is, it was actually a surprise for me when I started pulling palettes, because I was like, yeah, that color scheme is what I really want to play with in winter. It's from V Cosmetics. It's their Grimoire 2.0. And it's the darker, but more of the jewel tones that are in here. I find myself really wanting to play that, especially that brighter red here. So basically here on top, the red and then the gray. That is what really is drawing me in this time of year. Yeah, you know, the darker part of the year. Yeah, I think that's it. Those were the 10 palettes that when I open them up, I think of winter. And I noticed that I had quite a hard time articulating my thoughts on why. Usually I'm better at that, but today apparently I'm not. It was just a fun, quick video. I'm also going to do one for the holiday season. So if you want to see that one, make sure that you are subscribed. Let me know if you have any of these palettes. Let me know some of your winter palettes. Do you find yourself gravitating towards a specific color combination or specific types of colors in different seasons? Or are you just like
I smear everything on the face whenever the F I want to.
Let me know down below. And then this is it. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.